Welcome to this cluster control quick demo. Let's delve into the backup and recovery features of cluster control, which focuses on ensuring data continuity by performing point-in-time recovery. Managing backups across various service providers can be manual and time-consuming for DevOps teams. Cluster control acts as your centralized backup and recovery center for all your open-source databases. Plus, with a single pane of glass, you can view all your backups, regardless of the service or cloud provider you're using. This integral backup solution supports a wide range of recovery scenarios tailored to different database flavors and business needs. For this backup and recovery demo, we will use the Sovereign Galera cluster and navigate to the Backups tab to see all the backups available in this cluster. To start, let's see how easily you can create backups with Cluster Control. We will click on Create Backup. You will be met with an option to create a backup on demand, which is to create a backup instantly, or to schedule a periodic backup. For this quick demo, we will just create an on-demand backup. Here you see the configuration. You have options to select the node you wish to backup, the backup method and dump type. If you want to upload the backup to the cloud, toggle the option on, and you will see an extra configuration sequence for access to the cloud bucket you want to store your backup on. For this demo, we will be storing the backup on the node. In the advanced settings, we can do a more detailed configuration of the backup, from the retention period to enabling encryption. Configure storage options lets you choose where to store the backup, either on the node or on the controller. For this demo, we will be storing the backup on the node. We can also edit the default storage directory and subdirectory. Next, we can preview the settings, then create the backup, and we can see that the backup creation job will begin. After a few minutes or a few seconds, depending on the amount of data being backed up, you will see that the backup is completed. Moving on, performing point-in-time recovery with cluster control is seamless. Here's how you do it. First, we need to start the process by clicking Restore a Backup. You have two options: restoring from an external or internal backup source. For this demo, we will restore an internal backup. Next, we select the backup. Cluster control automatically detects the available backups. Select the backup you want to restore and specify where to restore it from. After that, we need to choose the restore method. In a disaster recovery scenario, where immediate recovery is crucial, select Restore on Node. Then let's enable point-in-time recovery. You can choose the node to restore the backup onto a temporary directory and make a copy of the data tier before restoring the backup. This is useful for postmortem analysis. Next, decide whether to bootstrap the cluster from the restored node. In this scenario, we are performing a full cluster outage recovery and need to configure the recovery. Lastly, we configure recovery options. Choose between time-based or position-based recovery. This decision is based on binary logs to pinpoint the exact position or time of recovery. For this demo, we set it to recover from just before 12 a.m. midnight, the point at which everything went haywire. Initially, only a single primary node of the cluster will be restored. Verify the integrity of the data set, as restoring a non-verified backup may cause server failures and unexpected results. Ensure the backup is verified, then click Continue. Finally, review the summary of the point-in-time recovery backup, and upon clicking Finish, the recovery process will start. We can view the recovery job here on the Jobs tab, and after a few minutes, the backup will be restored. That concludes this demo. Thanks for watching. Visit several9s.com/clustercontrol to either request a personalized demo with our support team, or you can try Cluster Control for yourself for 30 days starting today.